Welcome to the ARE 5.0 video prep series brought to you by NCARB. In this video, we'll take an in-depth look at the project management division. Project management is all about how to run a project throughout all of its phases. You should expect to see content related to developing and coordinating the project team, implementing office standards and quality control processes on a project, managing the project's client, fee, schedule, and risk, establishing a project's organizing principles, managing the consultants on the project team, and administering the contract requirements of the project. Topics related to running a practice before a contract is signed are covered in our practice management video. Effective project management includes establishing processes and protocols to ensure architects maintain an acceptable standard of care throughout the entire project. While the other ARE divisions are concerned with the specific tasks and skills needed to plan, design, detail, and construct a project, this one is focused on the operational aspects of running a project, such as schedule, budget, coordination, and team management. Ultimately, project management is about the competent delivery of architectural services. You've signed a contract to perform work, and now you need to execute the contract in a way that protects public health, safety, and welfare. Be sure to review the latest ARE 5.0 guidelines and ARE 5.0 handbook, both on the NCARB website. The guidelines contain critical information about ARE 5.0 policies, including the rolling clock, scheduling a test,
problems while testing,
and receiving your score. The handbook discusses the content of all six divisions and includes sample items and suggested references, as well as more information on the objectives for each division.
You have 3 hours to answer 75 questions in this division.
The content is distributed between resource management, project work planning, contracts, project execution, and project quality control. Once you have a signed contract, it's time to determine what resources you'll need to execute the project. In resource management, you will need to determine the composition of the project team and how each team member's time will be managed and allocated in order to execute the project. Let's look at a sample question. An architect has a total design budget of $300,000. To estimate the weekly hours for each member of the architectural design team, the following criteria must be considered. The design schedule for the project is 16 weeks long at 40 hours per week. 30% of the total design fee is allocated to design consultants. Firm goal is to achieve a 3.0 multiplier for all employees. 25% of the principal's time will be devoted to the project. Utilization of the project architect and architectural designer should be maximized. Drag the weekly hour allocations for each design team member from the left onto the labor schedule. Not all allocations will be used. This is the correct answer. In order to determine the number of hours to allocate for each design team member, begin by calculating the weekly direct rate budget and removing 30% for design consultants. This is done by dividing the maximum labor budget with design consultant fees removed by the company multiplier, then dividing by the weeks of the project. Allocate the principal's weekly hours to the project. The utilization rates of both the project architect and the architectural designer are to be maximized, meaning each of these project team members will allocate 40 hours per week on the project. This will provide you the remaining weekly budget to allocate to the project manager. Divide the $825 remaining by the project manager's rate. This is an AE level item. Because it requires you to evaluate the design budget, allocations for consultants, and company multiplier in order to determine the appropriate number of hours for each design team member. In the project work planning section, you'll evaluate effective ways to develop and communicate a work plan with the assembled team in order to complete the project. Let's look at a sample question. During the construction document phase, the owner requests changes that will delay permitting by 3 weeks, delay bidding by 2 weeks, and add an additional 3 weeks to the construction schedule. Click on the project completion point that reflects the impact of these changes. Each vertical line on the schedule represents 2 weeks. The correct answer is a 6-week delay. Delays to permitting will cause other items to be delayed, and the overall schedule will need to be adjusted. The delays to bidding and permitting are concurrent, so they push back the start of construction by 3 weeks. The construction timeline must be extended by an additional 3 weeks. The new completion date will be 6 weeks later. This is an AE level item because it requires you to analyze the impact of each of the delays and determine their effect on the overall project completion. In the contract section, you will analyze the contracts that establish relationships between the architect, owner, contractors, and consultants. Let's look at a sample question. At the end of the design development phase for an office park, the owner reports that a major tenant has backed out of the project. The owner delays the project 2 months to find a new tenant or secure additional funding. Working under AIA document B101, which of the following should the architect do during the 2-month project suspension? Check the three that apply. Request payment for design development. Request 2-month advance fee for construction documents. Prepare final bid package before ceasing work. Assist the owner in lining up a new tenant. Request payment for expenses incurred in the interruption of the architect's services. Submit revised schedule for when the project resumes. These are the correct answers. According to AIA document B101, if the owner suspends a project, the architect is entitled to payment for all expenses incurred up to that point. The architect can also request payment for expenses incurred because of the interruption. And if the project resumes, a revised schedule can be submitted. When an owner suspends a project, the architect should suspend work on the project, so requesting an advance or completing other work is unwise for the architect. While assisting the owner in lining up a tenant may get the project back on track, it is beyond the scope of a standard owner-architect relationship and is not the role of the architect. This is an AE level item because it expects you to understand this contract and how the delay results in both a suspension of work and consequences for both parties. This section assesses management of the project's execution. It is not about design-related decisions, but rather the necessary administrative procedures throughout the project. Let's look at a sample question. During the construction documents phase, the owner requests changes that will require 10 additional footings. The contractor has supplied the following cost information. Size of each footing, 4.5 feet by 4.5 feet by 36 feet. Crew labor cost, $175 per cubic yard. Material cost, including reinforcing, $225 per cubic yard. Miscellaneous equipment cost, $3 per cubic yard. Contractor's overhead and profit, 10%. The construction budget is $10 million, and the current construction cost is $9,900,000. How much over budget will this change request place the project? Round to the nearest whole dollar. The correct answer is $19,691. The owner's requested modification will increase the current construction budget. The architect must first determine the total cost of the requested change. To do so, determine the total volume of the additional footings. Then determine the total cost of the footings, including labor, materials, and miscellaneous equipment cost. The contractor's overhead and profit must all be included in the increased costs. The total cost of the additional footings and the current construction cost must then be compared to the construction budget amount. Because the dollar sign is in front of the answer box, only the numerals need to be entered, round to the nearest whole number as stated. This is an AE level item because it requires you to analyze the information given and calculate the increase in labor and materials compared to the current project budget. The Project Quality Control section analyzes quality control methods, procedures, and review processes in order to maintain the proper standard of care throughout the entire project. As with the previous sections, this is not about design-related decisions, but rather the necessary administrative procedures throughout the project. Let's look at a sample question. During a peer review of design documents for the local university's new business school building, the reviewer notes conflicting code references for means of egress on the life safety sheet. The architect should design to which of the following? The adopted code of the local jurisdiction, the adopted state building code, the ICC and NFPA model building codes, whichever adopted code is most stringent. This is the correct answer. The Architect's Handbook of Professional Practice discusses how most jurisdictions across the United States have adopted building codes based on the ICC family of codes. At the same time, both states and local jurisdictions have the authority to make changes to portions of the building codes. As the architect, you have a legal duty to design in compliance with all the codes that govern the type and location of the project. Researching the jurisdictions and requirements for a specific project is the responsibility of the architect. When multiple codes conflict, the most stringent code always takes precedence. This is a UA level item because it requires you to understand the relationship between codes and jurisdictions and then to apply them to a specific project. Ready to get started? Refer to the ARE handbook for a list of reference materials most often used to develop the questions included in this division. This is not an exhaustive list of all possible references, but a suggestion for further reading. And remember, lots of people are studying for the ARE right now, so join the conversation. You can stay on top of the latest news and connect with NCARB and your colleagues with these sites. Be sure to check out our ARE community created just for ARE 5.0 and take a look at our other ARE 5.0 division videos. Thanks for watching.